If you need coins for Madden 21, go to my sponsor, x5p.com. They have the cheapest and most reliable coins online, and use my code WIN, W-I-N, at checkout to save 5% off your order. Link in the description. Today, we're going to walk through the best theme teams in all of Madden 21, and I'm going to put together a top 5 list, and there's going to be some honorable mentions in there as well, of all the teams and why I think that they're the top 5 teams or theme teams in all of Madden 21. So we'll use the list, we'll also use a little bit of Mudhead to actually go through the teams individually, show you a little bit about what I'm thinking, the players on the teams, and do a full walkthrough of it. So if you guys are new to the channel, you like content like this, smash that like button. And if you're new, consider subscribing. Definitely helps me out as a small creator. But with that said, let's jump into the video. All right, guys, let's get into the top 5 theme team list here. And I'm going to put a couple honorable mentions in here just for the heck of it. Man, just thought, what the heck? It's my list. I can do what I want with it. So I am going to also walk through Mudhead a little bit. They'll walk through actually the players on the theme teams, but we're going to talk about the most important pieces of theme teams as well. So why do you want a theme team? A, it's going to increase speed, right? So if you have a 50 out of 50 theme team, meaning you have 50 players on that team on your squad, you're going to get +2 speed on your players. So if you combine that with Sprinter, you can get +4 speed overall. So theme teams have become a really big part of Madden 21. It's kind of the most popular thing to do, but there is also a couple different things you want to take into consideration. So where are your best bang for your buck, right, for positions where you want that speed? And where you want to focus is tight end, wide receivers, and cornerbacks. Those are the most important places that you want speed. And that's going to reflect in this list a little bit. So I'm going to start with the honorable mentions, though, and we'll move over to a little bit more of the actual top 5, and we'll do a deep dive into those. So the honorable mentions, though, I'm going to put the Falcons in at honorable mention number 1. And they've got a really solid squad here. I think as the year goes by and we get a couple upgrades, they're going to get even better. A decent offensive line. You've got Tony Gonzalez, which is a pretty solid tight end, and you get +4 speed on him. Hey, we're going to be really talking about a pretty fast tight end there. But their main weakness currently is wide receiver. Kelvin Ridley being their best wide receiver who's not named Andre Johnson that everybody gets. But when they get a Julio Jones upgrade, that's going to be huge for them, and they're going to have a really, really formidable squad. Might also see a Roddy White. I don't know if we ever see him this year, but defense also really solid. The weakness is the free safety spot, but Lawyer Malloy at strong safety and very, very decent and more than decent cornerbacks on the squad as well. So you got Dion, AJ Terrell, D'Angelo Hall, Asante Samuel. These are all very, very good cornerbacks, and they really benefit from the +2, +4 speed. And then also really good pass rushers and defensive linemen. So solid squad overall, not quite into my top 5, but really, really like them. I'm also actually going to throw the Cardinals in here as an honorable mention. They've got kind of the same problem as Atlanta right now, where they've got a really, really good defense, a very mediocre receiving core. So they've a decent offensive line, very weak on the right side. Todd Heap, not really loving that, but it is what it is. So as we kind of look at, and I think I said Ravens there, but I meant Falcons, but Todd Heap, kind of oh-hum as a tight end. So as you can see here, the wide receiving core is the problem. Very slow across the board. Larry Fitzgerald, DeAndre Hopkins, Andre Johnson. You do have Jim Thorpe. You got, you know, Adrian Peterson, Barry Sanders, whatever. Kyler Murray's great, but not a whole heck of a lot there on offense. But the defense is very, very good. So if you wanted to go 25 out of 50, Cardinals would be a really good choice for that, because you've got Buda Baker, you've got Adrian Wilson, and then you've got a very good cornerback core as well with Antonio Cromartie, who just came out. That is an LTD, but still very, very good. Patrick Peterson sitting there in Night Train Lane. I'd probably use DRC over Night Train Lane because he's faster, and then Entrell Roll as well. And then, you know, decent on the defensive line also. So very solid core there. And then I'm also going to slap in the Chiefs, and I'm just going to keep going here, and I'm going to put the Seahawks in here as well. So I'll start with, actually, I don't know who I'll start with, whoever's closer here. So I think it's going to be Kansas City. I'll start with the Chiefs, and I think the Chiefs are a lot better for those of you who want to use a 25 out of 50 theme team. And I'll explain why here in a second. So first of all, you do get Tony Gonzalez, so not the fastest tight end in the game, but still very, very good and faster than a lot of tight ends. decent offensive line, actually very good offensive line, not just decent, very, very good offensive line. But here's where it starts coming in to be a problem a little bit. So the wide receivers are decent. Again, you've got Tyreek Hill. Now, I'm going to mention something about Tyreek Hill and the cornerbacks here in a second, but Jamaal Charles, very good. Rich Gannon, they say they shadow buffed him. Great. Maybe he's a little bit better right now, but really like that card as well. Hot route master and gunslinger. Patrick Mahomes, we didn't get a Super Bowl MVP upgrade, but we should be getting an upgrade sometime soon. Defense, very, very good. Kendall Fuller, Tyrann Mathieu. You got one of the best pass rushers, if not the best pass rusher in the game with Derek Thomas. And then cornerbacks, very solid as well. Ladarius Sneed, Breeland, Revis, Marcus Peters, decent defensive line also. So here's what I want to talk about with the Chiefs. They are better as a 25 out of 50 theme team because Ladarius Sneed, if you have him on a 25 out of 50 theme team, he's going to get the 99 speed if you've got him powered up. Marcus Peters, you've got him on a 25 out of 50 theme team. If you've got him powered up, he's going to get the 99 speed. You do not need to get to a 50 out of 50 theme team to get those players to 99 speed. And then if you combine that with a Deion Sanders, you're going to have three 99 speed cornerbacks on your team at 25 out of 50. So really, really valuable there. Then you've got the same story with Tyreek Hill. He doesn't need to be on a theme team at all to get the 99 speed. So really, really like that card, but probably not a team that you should focus on as a full 50 out of 50 theme team. You just don't get the full benefit out of it. And then Seahawks, they've got some really good pieces, but they've also got some kind of holes in their offense. And the main hole in their offense is the tight end. They just don't have a very solid and serviceable tight end in that spot, but everything else pretty decent across the board. DK Metcalf's going to get the 99 speed. Marcel Reese is a very nice plus to have a very fast fullback in there. You're going to have a 99 speed halfback. Russell Wilson's very good and serviceable. Jerry Rice, obviously very nice to have. Defense, you've got Jamaal Adams. You've got a very good cornerback core. Wish they were a little bit faster, but it's kind of more so built for a zone team, to be honest, because Richard Sherman is tall, not as fast, but still very good. Shaq Griffin, probably going to get an upgrade soon. Justin Coleman sitting there. So solid team overall, but still a couple holes in it, not worthy of the top five. So now we're going to move to the top five, and at number five, I'm going to put the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So Tampa Bay Buccaneers definitely benefited a little bit from the Super Bowl, right? Got a lot of cards recently. They got a lot of upgrades into a lot of the skill positions. Their main weakness, again, I'm going to talk about it, is the tight ends position. And Gronk, probably the best tight end in all of history, but still very, very slow, and that is the main problem with him in this game. He's just never been given the proper speed that he needs to be a full-fledged powerhouse at tight end in Madden. So that's your weakness on this squad, but overall on offense, very, very solid. You have Tom Brady, obviously. You've got Warwick Dunn, Leonard Fournette even sitting down here at a sneaking 94. Mike Alstott at a 95 fullback, that's huge as well. And then your wide receiver core is very, very good with a full Bucks theme team, right? Chris Godwin, Keenan McCardell, Mike Evans, these are all going to be very fast, very tall wide receivers. Mike Evans is going to be 6'5 and 99 speed on a full theme team. But then additionally, the defense, very solid here. Antoine Winfield, John Lynch, probably going to get an upgrade at some point as well. And then you do have very serviceable cornerbacks also. So Rondae Barber, Jarrell Revis, Sean Murphy Bunting, all very, very good cornerbacks and strong defense there. All right, and then number four on the theme team list, we've got the Baltimore Ravens. Now, the Baltimore Ravens, they're so close to being just absolutely overpowered, right? And let's go to them here quickly. And the reason is they're one of the first teams on the list here that gets a full, like, scary tight end, right? This tight end, full theme team, 97 speed tight end. Darren Waller, 97 speed, so, so huge. Great offensive line, maybe the best offensive line in the game on a full theme team. Where their weakness lies is the wide receiver spot. So you've got Steve Smith, but that's really about it, right? You do have a sneaky Raheem Mostert sitting back here. You've got Randall Cunningham, Patrick Ricard, very good at halfback and fullback. You've got Eric Weddle, maybe the best free safety in the game on a full theme team. Great running, middle linebacker, or just linebacker core in general. You've got Adalius Thomas, one of the best pass rushers in the game. And then very, very good cornerback core. Deion Sanders, Marcus Peters, Rod Woodson. Decent defensive line also. So definitely in my top five, but not quite top, top tier. Moving to the next ones here. So I've got a little bit of a cop-out. I've got a tie for the second and third spot, and I'm putting San Francisco and Las Vegas in there. So they're very, very similar teams, so I'm just maybe going to go to San Francisco and We'll maybe skip going over Vegas because they're almost the exact same team, but San Francisco is maybe a little bit of an edge on them just because of this guy right here. So Vernon Davis, solid card here. So he's one speed faster than Darren Waller. So you're going to have just a little bit of an uptick at the tight end position there. So 98 speed versus 97 on a full theme team. And then you've also got Isaac Bruce. So the Raiders... they do not get Isaac Bruce, but they do get Jerry Rice. They do get Randy Moss. And then, you know, the Raiders have Rich Gannon. The 49ers have Jimmy Garoppolo. Very similar quarterback, same archetype, same-ish speed, everything like that. And then Raheem Mostert also sitting here as a backup for the 49ers, where the Raiders have Bo Jackson. So it's a give and take there. And then Raiders have Marcel Reese. 49ers have Juszczyk. And then defensively here, here's where a lot of things are similar, but there's just some small differences as well. Both have Asamoa. The 49ers actually get Deion as a theme team. You don't really need Deion in a theme team. He's going to get 99 speed regardless of what team he's on. But Richard Sherman sitting here, Rod Woodson as well. Very, very good cornerbacks. And then the difference here is currently you've got the 49ers with Jimmy Ward and Tart at the safety positions, where the Raiders have Taylor Mays and Ronnie Lott as their top tier safeties right now. So both of these two, Ronnie Lott and Taylor Mays, I expect to get upgrades. Ronnie Lott probably sooner than Mays, but when those come into the game, those are going to be just top tier best safeties in the game as well. But the Raiders and the 49ers, very similar theme teams, like them both, and you really can't go wrong either way. And then my top theme team in the game right now is the Washington football team. And that is mainly because they're great at absolutely every position. I mean, there's almost no weakness on their team right now. When this Vernon Davis card came out, it made them top tier. Because Vernon Davis also goes on the Washington football team, you're going to see just all over the board, they're great. So Vernon Davis right here, he's going to get the 98 speed on a Washington football full theme team. But you got Alex Smith. You've even got sneaky Kirk Cousins if you can't afford Alex Smith. Both a field general archetype. I think that's the best archetype in the game, in my opinion. 99's being Sean Alexander. You've also got DeSean Jackson, Terry McLaurin, Santana Moss, Keenan McCardell. So great, great wide receiving core. All of those, I think, get to 99 speed except for Keenan McCardell. But I think all of these three on a full Washington football theme team get to 99 speed. And then defense, it doesn't stop here. Sean Taylor, Landon Collins, and then the cornerback core and the defensive line, top tier in the game. Deion, D'Angelo Hall, Champ Bailey, Troy Vincent. You've even got sneaky DRC sitting back here. And then Chase Young, Montez Sweat. I mean, these two just alone are really, really fast on the defensive line and very, very good. Both of them absolutely top tier pass rushers right now. So that is my list, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Top five theme teams in the game right now, again, with some honorable mentions again, but let me know what your thoughts are. Where would you rank some of these teams? Who would you swap out? Who are you rocking right now as a theme team as well? But if you're new to the channel, again, like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell for when we drop new videos. And if you like content like this, smash that like button. Do me a favor. Helps me out as a small creator and helps me grow. But with that said, like I always tell next time, win Madden.